Knowledge areas are a logical organization of project management processes according to their specific area of concern. Project management knowledge areas include project integration management, that ensures the coordination of the different project management knowledge areas, protecting their consistency and alignment to project constraints and stakeholders' expectations. Project scope management, that ensures that all the required work is performed and only the required work is performed. Project schedule management, that ensures the project is delivered on schedule. Project cost management, that ensures the project is completed within approved budget. Project quality management, that ensures that the project, the product, and the adopted processes meet requirements. Project resource management, that ensures that the project required resources are identified, acquired, and managed throughout the project. Project communications management, that ensures that information is collected, processes, and distributed according to communication requirements. Project risk management, that ensures that risks are identified, analyzed, responded to, and monitored throughout the project. Project procurement management, that includes all processes required to acquire products and services from external sources, and administer the contracts or agreements associated with those acquisitions. And finally, project stakeholder management, that ensures that stakeholders are identified and understood and that effectively engaged in the project. Process groups represent the second dimension of the project management framework. Process groups are used to categorize processes according to their purpose. According to the PMBok Guide, 6th edition, there are 5 project management process groups. Initiating, that defines and authorizes the project or phase. Planning, that defines project objectives and the actions required to attain them. Executing, that coordinates all the resources to carry out the plan. Monitoring and controlling, that measures progress to identify variances and take corrective or preventive action. And finally, closing, that brings the project or phase to a controlled end. Process groups are not phases. In fact, all process groups can be required to complete a phase successfully. The initiating process group includes all the processes required to authorize the start of a project or phase, as well as to establish a common vision. You may think of the initiating process group as an understanding effort of what lays behind the project, such as business need, project justification, organization context, stakeholders' environment, and accumulated historical information, as well as an high-level understanding, or vision, of what lays ahead, such as high-level scope, high-level schedule, and overall project risk. Initiating also acts as a constitution that establishes boundaries that will guide and frame future decisions. Let's look at some of the key initiating activities. Selecting the project manager. Delegating to the project manager the authority to use organizational resources on the project. Identifying stakeholders and understanding their influence over the project. Understanding the project's business need, justification, and strategic alignment. Collecting and understanding the project business case. Translating stakeholders' expectations and needs into high-level requirements. Providing a high-level description. Understanding the overall project risks. Defining success criteria. Defining initial high-level plans, such as a schedule, a budget, and an organization chart. And formally authorizing the start of the project or phase. Projects should be initiated. Still, many organizations incorrectly skip initiation and jump straight into planning. Some of the symptoms of lack of project initiation are unrealistic constraints, lack of stakeholders' involvement, and constant project changes. The following image represents the processes included in the initiating process group. The planning process group includes all the processes required to define, refine, and formalize objectives, as well as to determine the necessary actions to attain them. Planning should not be exclusively performed by the project manager. The project manager should engage team members, team managers, the customer, the sponsor, and other relevant stakeholders in order to create robust plans. Engaging stakeholders in the planning effort also helps to generate the awareness and commitment that can minimize resistance, avoid disruptive changes, and facilitate customer acceptance. Planning activities cross all project management knowledge areas and may include defining the rules on how the project will be managed, which processes will be used, and how they will be implemented, elaborating detailed level constraints and assumptions, collecting product requirements, defining the project scope, identifying and describing the project deliverables, decomposing the work into smaller elements, WBS, and describing the work elements for future reference, WBS dictionary, identifying and sequencing activities, estimating durations, developing the schedule, estimating costs and determining budget, determining quality standards and metrics and establishing quality management processes, defining how resources will be acquired, controlled and released, estimating resource requirements, plan roles and responsibilities, establishing hierarchical relationships and recognition and rewards criteria, defining communication requirements and determining who can provide such information, defining what, when and how to procure, preparing procurement documents, determining how stakeholders will be managed, identifying, analyzing and responding to risks, performing the necessary iterations to develop a coherent and integrated plan, managing conflicts with existing constraints, initial objectives and expectations, obtaining a project management plan formal acceptance and establishing project baselines, and communicating the project management plan. The following image represents the processes included in planning. The executing process group includes all the processes required to carry out the plan, complete the project deliverables, and coordinate the resources required to execute the plan. In addition to producing deliverables, such as building walls, repairing engines, or developing software, The executing process group will carry out management plans, performing project management work required to achieve the objectives, such as recruiting staff, distributing information, or selecting suppliers. Examples of executing activities include completing the project deliverables, providing work performance data, requesting changes, completing the approved corrective actions, preventive actions, and defect repairs, documenting lessons learned, performing quality audits, analyzing processes to identify improvement opportunities, acquiring human resources, obtaining the team necessary training, assessing the team's performance, performing team building activities, solving problems and disputes, distributing information according to the communications management plan, managing the involvement and commitment of project stakeholders, and reviewing suppliers' proposals and negotiating contracts. The following image represents the processes included in executing. The monitoring and controlling process group includes all the processes required to align the actual performance with the planned performance and align the plan with value. Examples of monitoring and controlling activities include assessing actual project performance, analyzing variances, recommending corrective or preventive actions, forecasting performance, recommending preventive actions when a potential variance is forecasted, identifying changes, assessing the impact of changes, and approving or reject changes. The monitoring and controlling key activities are used across the project knowledge areas with slight adaptations of terminology. For example, in the quality management area, would perform inspections, identify defects, and perform defect repair, instead of determining actual performance, assess variances, and issue corrective actions. The following image represents the processes included in monitoring and controlling. The closing process group includes all the processes required to bring a formal and controlled end to the phase, project, or contract. The closing activities ensure that the project or phase have been formally accepted, that the product is properly transferred to operations or to the next phase, and that the project is properly decommissioned. While closing, the project management team may verify if the product was delivered as required, verify if the phase or project acceptance criteria were met, decide on whether to advance to the next project phase, obtain the formal acceptance to close the project or phase, transfer the product to operations, manage the project termination before completion, collect final lessons learned, update organizational process assets with the acquired lessons learned, produce a final project performance report, archive project documentation. and release resources. The following image represents the processes included in closing. For the PMP exam, you should be able to distinguish a project life cycle from project management process groups. As previously discussed, the project life cycle is a collection of phases that describe how the project's product is performed. Although there is a generic project life cycle framework, different projects may adopt different life cycles. Process groups, on the other hand, describe how the project will be managed, segregating the project management processes according to their purpose. Process groups are the same for every project, because all projects should be initiated, planned, executed, monitored and controlled, and closed. Another difference has to do to how phases and processes group flow. Phases are usually completed sequentially. With some degree of overlapping, the deliverables of one phase may be used as inputs into the activities of future phases. Process groups are performed concurrently. For example, we must monitor while executing, and iteratively. For example, monitoring and controlling activities can lead into further planning. In fact, all process groups can be required to complete a phase successfully. In other words, initiating, planning, executing, monitoring and controlling, and closing can be applied to a project or to a phase. Applying process groups to the project, as well as the phase, ensures that the project retains a detailed control over the short term. The phase, while still maintaining a vision over the project. When will we finish? How much will it cost? On small projects, with one single phase, there is only one cycle of initiating, planning, executing, monitoring and controlling, and closing. On more complex projects, process groups may be repeated in each phase to guide the project toward completion. Therefore, initiating, planning, executing, monitoring and controlling, and closing can be applied to a project or to a phase. This video was developed by XPM Consulting. XPM is a project management, agile, IT and leadership training company. Thank you for watching. We hope you found the video interesting, and if you did, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel.